As you know, in 2011, Diocesan Convention affirmed the principle of the tithe. And in 2012, Convention set the goal of designating 10% of the diocesan budget for mission and outreach by 2018. And guess what? We did it! Here's what you're giving away for mission and outreach within the diocese. You are helping provide school supplies for 70 children who otherwise would show up at Cato Elementary School without anything. Your money will purchase a storage building for Helping Hands, a Hamilton organization that provides residents in need with air conditioners, heaters, and other small building and repair needs. The shed will sit on St. Mary's property, and St. Mary's will provide shelving and storage racks and will store the tools used by Helping Hands. Susan Kleinwechter of St. Martin's explains the impact of Service Sunday.
Service Sunday at St. Martin's is a year-round food ministry on the second Sunday of each month. An intergenerational group faithfully makes 200 sack lunches for the people served by Union Gospel Mission of Tarrant County. We're transformed while we work together to feed others.
You are helping to provide shoes to the men of Union Gospel Mission, allowing each resident to get a pair of new shoes tailored to fit his own needs, likely the only opportunity many get to select their own footwear. The shoes are provided before the cold weather hits. Three to 400 students at Tarleton State University are getting a home-cooked meal every Thursday because of your help. Last year, 28 volunteers served meals for approximately 8,400 students. St. Luke's feeds them and loves them. And while the lunches are fun, hunger is a growing concern on college campuses, with food insecurity among students growing. In fact, the Tarleton campus qualifies for a food bank. Last year, Christian Community Assistance served 6,000 clients. This year, your money will be buying new socks and underwear, primarily for people referred by the Tarrant County Parole Office. The parolees often have only the clothes they were released with. You also are helping with other non-food essentials, such as personal hygiene items. Coffee in Conversation is an outreach concept that developed through living room conversations hosted monthly by St. Luke's. The church wants to be a welcoming and helpful place to immigrant families in the neighborhood.
So now we have people come every week and bring their own coffee mugs and fill them up. And we have friends in the neighborhood, from junior high boys talking about getting a new instrument and joining the mariachi band, or how well their football team did the night before, to pray for me and my marriage, we're having a tough time. How do you say banana in Spanish, and how do you say apple in Spanish, and are you going to remember next week? How about you teach us English and we'll teach you Spanish?
You are helping St. Christopher's Laundry Love Ministry help people do their laundry. Sounds simple, doesn't it? The ability to do laundry is a basic human need taken for granted by most of us, but not for those living in poverty who may have to choose between paying the rent or going to the laundromat.
So we're the only place in Fort Worth that's doing laundry love. Today is our 1 year anniversary. We've grown from 30 loads to 500 loads a month.
Remember when I mentioned earlier about hunger on college campuses increasing? Research shows that 1 in 5 college students qualify as hungry. Your money will help St. Albans create an extension of the Four Saints Food Pantry to serve UTA international students. You're also giving away money outside the diocese. The Hoshone Wellness Center in Farmington, New Mexico will provide counseling, health and occupational training, drug and alcohol recovery, and pastoral care to Navajo women and children who are disproportionately affected by the extreme poverty, addiction, and generational harm to Navajo family systems. Hoshone is Navajo for balance or wholeness. The Wellness Center will incorporate Navajo culture and spirituality with Christ-centered ministry. All Saints is the primary source of support for the Amazing Grace Children's Home and Amazing Grace Girls School in Kenya. Since the school opened its doors in 2013, girls have graduated from high school and gone on to college. Your money helps All Saints continue their support of the girls through high school and into college. In 2017, a devastating earthquake hit southwestern Mexico, about 80 miles from Hogar Infantil, a children's home in Chiapas. The girls' dorm was damaged and deemed unsafe to house children. So 31 girls, ages 3 through 20, are currently packed into a three-bedroom house. Your money will be helping with repairs. With your assistance, this leprosy medical mission will be buying medicines, bandages, splints, and other medical supplies for a clinic run by our own Dr. Andy Babbley. Children of leprosy families will receive their educational needs and learn to take care of their parents and other family members. The Zambian Assistance Project was born because Zambia had historically hidden or abused people with speech problems. But that's changing because of the successful training of 18 Zambian speech therapists and an ongoing training program for more. You are helping to continue that training by assisting with tuition, textbooks, fees, and other supplies. You are helping give a voice to the voiceless.